Today on the show, I'm going to take a look at the world of photography and the balance of it with your mental health. Stay tuned.
Podcasts you love
from people you trust.
This is TWIT.
This episode of Hands on Photography is brought to you by AG1 by Athletic Greens. If you're looking for a simpler and cost-effective supplement routine, AG1 is giving you a free one-year supply of vitamin D and 5 free travel packs with your first purchase of a subscription. Go to athleticgreens.com/hop. Hey folks, I am Matt Pruitt, and today we're going to dive into the world of photography and mental health. Yes, I wanted to bring this up because May is Mental Health Awareness Month here in the U.S. I don't know if it is around the rest of the world, but I didn't really dive into bringing, you know, the whole Mental Health Awareness Month celebration upfront because, quite honestly, I feel like I talk about it pretty regularly, whether it's Mental Health Awareness Month or not. But here recently, I've been perusing the good old internets and reading some stories, and it struck a nerve, struck a chord with me, if you will. And I said, you know what? I'm going to bring this up on the show, Hands on Photography, and share it with all of my awesome Hands on Photography listeners and communities, as well as get some feedback from them. So without further ado, I got two stories. One is from fstoppers.com, and the other is from Petapixel. But let me just go ahead and share my screen and we'll take a look at those stories. So this one here from fstoppers, the title, it says, "Are you making this common mistake when dealing with failure?" And this comes from, I'm not sure how to pronounce the author's name, but it looks like Ija Avchar. Not sure. I'm sorry for butchering your name, but I thought this was a compelling story. But again, thinking about the common mistakes when dealing with failure as a photographer, and reading through it, and it all sounded fairly similar, because I can't speak for you as a hands-on photography listener and viewer, but you know, I've had moments where things just didn't quite work out in the world of photography. You know, a shoot didn't go well and I had to go back and redo it, or a product shot that I was working on was just totally frustrating, and it was really, really messing with my head. And then you get to the point where things are not working out, and you find yourself going through, as I mentioned here, a fast track to burning out. Now, burnout with anything, folks, can happen when you deal with a road of frustration and some trials and obstacles, if you will. I don't care if it's photography. I don't care if it's even just trying to be an athlete, athletes that train over and over and over again, but never quite seem to get the podium. They tend to burn out during that process until they hit that podium, you know? So a lot of times just hitting failure can really, really be frustrating, and you have to find a way to fight through that. And that goes for photography as well. You know, I know everybody is all over the stuff with social media, be it Instagram or Flickr or I don't know, whatever is on the Fediverse. And you're like, man, these photos I'm snapping, I think they look great, but nothing is happening as far as giving me extra likes or giving me extra attention and exposure from other folks, or getting me extra jobs or gigs or what have you. And that could be rather frustrating. I know, been there, done that, still been there, done that. But we have to continue to push through. We don't want this stuff that is being a bit of a hindrance in our progression to totally stop us from producing and progressing, as well as leading to other problems with our mental health. Unfortunately, I've seen people get into different arts and crafts, and things just they don't quite pan out the way they hope they pan out, and they go into a depressive state. And that's very, very, very unfortunate. And I'm reading through this article again, and it talks about taking a better approach when dealing with failure and when dealing with mistakes and things that happen. Sometimes the old adage of working smarter, not harder, isn't the way to go. I mean, it is the way to go most of the time, but sometimes you have to dig a little bit deeper. So it depends on your particular scenario. I know growing up, for me, The old adage of you need to work hard, you need to work hard, was pounded into my head when sometimes I just needed to work smarter. You know, why didn't someone tell me that back in the day? Hey, work smarter, Aunt, and then things will work out. So it was a lot of stuff like that that just really bounced around in my head. And then I went down to the closing thoughts on here, and I love how it says this here. Before signing off, I would like to stress that the traditional approach of simply trying harder won't cut it in the modern climate. It is simply not a viable success strategy. It leads to frustration, burnout, and ultimately giving up. That is so dadgum true. So dadgum true. And again, folks, in this world of photography, I like to urge you, if this is something that you enjoy doing, continue to do it. Just keep pushing along. You're going to have some bumps in the roads. You're going to have some obstacles and things that sort of try to trip you up, but just keep staying the course and enjoying the journey. But there is another article I wanted to touch on regarding this particular story. But before I do that, I want to thank this week's fine sponsor, the good old folks that I'm going to flex my biceps right here, Athletic Greens. This episode of Hands Over Photography is brought to you by AG1 by Athletic Greens. Like countless others, I wanted to support my health without incorporating more pills or sacrificing my taste buds. With AG1 by Athletic Greens, I'm able to give my body what it craves all in one daily nutritional drink. Yes, every morning I grab it. Oh, so good. AG1 was founded in 2010 and has been a part of millions of routines since. AG1 is the best all-in-one solution for daily nutrition. It saves you time, confusion, and money, and in each serving costs less than $3 a day. Individual supplements can add up pretty quickly. Trust me, I know, I've been down that road. Plus, AG1's daily habit gives you powerful, long-term results. AG1 makes it easier for you to take the highest quality supplements, whether it's improving digestion or supporting you with better sleep. AG1 is the best bang for your buck. AG1 is a seamless and easy daily habit. Just one scoop of AG1 in the morning covers your entire day's nutritional basis. Get all your supplements and support your long-term gut health with AG1's 75 high-quality minerals, vitamins, pre and probiotics. I've been on this AG1 train for quite a while now, and I'm going to tell you, yes, I sing its praises. It makes my body feel really, really dadgum good, and having proper gut health is just going to go a long way in making sure all aspects of that is going to work out for you. Highly, highly recommend. If you're looking for a simpler and cost-effective supplement routine, AG1 by Athletic Greens is giving you a free one-year supply of vitamin D and 5 free travel packs with your first purchase of a subscription. Go to athleticgreens.com/hop. Again, that is athleticgreens.com/hop, and check them out. Now, next up, I want to take a look at this other story, because again, we're talking about battling frustration and making sure we're keeping your mental health in check when it comes to the world of photography. And one way to battle frustration with photography, again, is there's a couple ways. Sometimes I like to tell people to just if you're working on a project and it's starting to just sort of frustrate you because it ain't quite coming out right just yet, you can step away from the computer for an hour or two. Step away from the computer, step away from the product that you're shooting for an hour, and just sort of allow yourself to just exhale and take it all in and sort of recharge. And then you go back to it and it tends to work out. At least it does in my instance. There's a lot of times I'm working on headshots or whatever, and for whatever reason, that model, they're not looking as good as I thought they would look in my mind's eye. And a lot of times it's because I needed to step away from Adobe Lightroom for a few minutes and then come back and I was good to go. But there's some other things that you can do other than that, that's taking up personal projects. So here on this next article from the folks at petapixel.com, written by Brenda Bergreen, I believe. Brenda says, what I actually love about personal photography projects. Yes. That is one way that you can help fight against, you know, the battles of your mental health. Pick up a personal project. Don't necessarily work on something that is being shot for for a client of yours that's paying for the gig, pick up a personal project. And this could be anything. We've talked about this in the past. You know, every one of us likes to get up out of our bed in the morning. Yes, I said everyone likes to get up out of our bed in the morning and have a cup of coffee. I know all of y'all want you coffee every morning. You're not fooling me. Well, turn your coffee experience into a photo project, just a personal photo project. You know how good that coffee makes you feel. It'll probably make you feel just as good, if not even better, turning that experience into a photo or turning that experience into a video sequence, if you will. So you can dive into that project, take advantage of the natural light that you have in the kitchen or what have you. Take advantage of using some of your additional lights if you want to. Have fun with textures, have fun with scattering the beans all over the place, or and just really make it yours. Just have fun with the project because it's your project. It's not the client's, it's yours, and you can make it look and feel exactly how you want to, and just take some pride in that. And I gotta tell you, doing those personal projects go a long, long, long way. So I highly recommend you try out a personal project. Now, if you haven't tried a personal project and you're looking for some ideas, hit me up. Let me know. I could share a couple of different tips with you. Just send a message to hop@twit.tv to let you know some different things that you can try, because the personal project doesn't have to be expensive. Okay. It doesn't have to be a very elaborate product shoot or what have you. It could be a lot of different things. So just reach out to me and let me know if you have some questions. I'd love to help you out with this and help keep you on the even keel and happy side of things when it comes to your mental health and photography. All right, that's going to do it for me this week, folks. Thank you all for hanging out each and every week. I really do appreciate all the support. Make sure you continue to subscribe and share the show out with everybody that you know, including a friend and enemy. Just let everybody know about hands-on photography. Goes a long way. Check out our website, twit.tv/HOP, for hands-on photography. And you'll see all of our previous episodes and previous show notes and even our previous guests. And yeah, just spread the word. Keep growing the show. I really do appreciate the support. All right. Thank you again. Thank you to my man, Mr. Victor, for making me look and sound good each and every week. Hey, safely create, dominate, and keep a safe eye on your mental health, folks. And I'll see you next time. Tech experts Leo Laporte and Micah Sargent team up to answer all your burning tech questions. From the latest gadgets to tried and true tech tips, Leo and Micah have the knowledge and expertise to help you get the most out of your technology. So whether you're a tech novice or a seasoned pro, join Leo and Micah each week for a fun and informative look at the world of technology. Give us a call with your live tech questions from 11 a.m. Pacific to 2 p.m. Pacific every Sunday via Zoom at call.twit.tv, or better yet, you can just call us on our new phone number, 888-724-ATTG. Again, call us via the phone at 888-724-ATTG.